servant. Please extend the hymn book to the choir, please. Before you sing the song, I want to advise you a little before you begin to sing the song. The book, the hymn book may not extend to everybody.
E-S-U-S. Jesus.
He said, I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. He's the lily of the valley. In him alone I see. In him alone. Alone. No duplicates anywhere. All I need to cleanse and make me fully whole. In sorrow, he comforts me. He don't take my sorrow to mock me. He don't take my sorrow to disgust me at my back. He don't carry my sorrow to his group of talkatives. In trouble, he's my stay. He don't pray that my trouble multiply. Rather, he helped my trouble to come to an end. He tells me every care on him to roll. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. I believe after singing this song, you will choose to make him a friend.
Yeah.
feel. When I cry out, I sing glory. I sing His blessed voice. The voice of the light shall ever rule.
Celebrate with you in 2019. I decree and open.
heaven for you.
Amen.
Whatsoever God will do for us that will make our enemies to be put to shame, may it happen this week.
Amen.
Whatsoever God will do for this church, for the enemies of this church to put to shame, may it happen this week.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anywhere you are under the sound of my voice, may the God Almighty whom I serve break every spiritual and physical yoke in your life.
Amen.
Break every demonic chain holding you from your father's house.
Amen.
Destroy every marital yoke holding you from your father's side.
Amen.
And open your doors of next level.
Amen.
May you cross the line.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We have defeated you before. From today, you will defeat them.
Amen.
We had to stop you before. From today, you will overcome.
Amen.
We had you fail before. From today, say, I am a winner.
I am a winner.
Say, I will win.
I will win.
Then we lose.
Then we lose.
I can't hear you.
Say, I will win.
I will win.
Then we lose.
Then we lose.
I begin to win.
I begin to win.
I begin to lose.
They begin to lose.
In the name of Jesus. Lift up your right hand. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any cancer.
Any cancer.
They have taken.
They have taken.
At our back.
At our back.
Against us.
Against us.
Against the church.
Against the church.
Against you.
Against me.
Against me.
Against you.
Against the prophet.
Against the prophet.
We decree.
We decree.
Let them scatter.
Let them scatter.
Let them put to shame.
Let them put to shame.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Appreciate the Lord.
Have your seat in the presence of the Lord.
I want to use this opportunity to welcome the viewers all over the world. Anywhere you are watching this program, you are watching Holy Congregation Church International. Today is anointing service. It's going to be great and wonderful. Invite your friends, share the page, comment. And expect your miracle today. I'm promising you, you will return home the way you came.
Amen.
And I want to thank all the workers and the leaders and ministers that have set things in order before I came in. And all the friends that are joining up for the first time. I'm promising you that you are going home with the packages of miracles.
Amen.
Shout a bigger amen.
Amen.
By the special grace of God, today is the 10th day of our marathon praying and fasting. By the special grace of God, the Lord has been great, faithful, and wonderful for us. For the people that queue in into this marathon journey, many are testifying already what God is doing in their lives and what God is doing in the church spiritually, which I'm not going to mention. I want to thank you all that are praying and joining the fasting. Believe in me, the husbandman that labors is going to be the first partaker of the fruit.
Amen.
This fasting is really chosen by the Lord. It's really chosen by the Lord. Today is the 10th day. And it is great. Say it's great.
It's great.
If you are not joining the fasting, I am sorry. Church, tell the people that are not joining, tell them sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. And in most cases, the people shouting sorry more than the people that are not fasting. Amen. This morning, I have a little message I want to share with you. Message I titled, Understanding the Power of Prayer with Fasting. Say amen.
Amen.
Understanding the power. Say understanding.
Understanding.
The power
of prayer.
And fasting.
Fasting.
Amen.
Amen.
There is two different things there. Number one is prayer. Number two is fasting. You can fast and you're not praying. You can pray and you're not fasting. It's two different things altogether. But when you combine the two together, you understand the benefits, the goodies, the blessing, the breakthrough, the deliverance that follow prayer with fasting. You can be praying and shouting and screaming, but you have not fasted. That one is prayer. You may be fasting 6 to 6, 6 to 3, 6 to 12. In that fasting, you never make any reasonable prayer point. You are fasting, but you are not praying. Many of us here are queued in into this fasting. Prophet, I started by 6, I'm closing by 3, but they never pray for 5 minutes. You are not fasting and praying. You are in hunger strike. You are in hunger strike. What matters is not that you are not eating. What matters is the word coming out from your mouth in that period that you are not eating. God is not listening to fasting because fasting doesn't speak. But what God is after is the word that came out of your mouth in the time of the fasting. That's what works. The supplication, the word of your mouth, the utterance that moves out from your lips is what God listed, what he counted, what he used to work for you. Say amen.
Amen.
Let's see the word of God in the book of Joel chapter 2. Joel chapter 2, I read from 12. Joel chapter 2. Joel. Joel is one of the minor prophets. I read from Jesus. Therefore also now saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart and with fasting and with weeping and with mourning, and rent your heart and not your garment, and turn unto the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of a great kindness, and repenting him of the evil. 14. Who knoweth if he will return and repent and leave a blessing behind him, even a meat offering and a drink offering unto the Lord our God? 15 said, blow the trumpet in Zion. Blow the trumpet in a sanctuary of Holy Covenant, Adoration Church International, Panama. Blow the trumpet in Zion and sanctify a fast. Call a solemn assembly. Sanctify a fast. A fasting is obligatory. That the whole assembly will move into the fasting. Sister, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that suck the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth to his chamber, and the bride out of her closet. Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep between the porch and the altar. And let them say, spare thy people, O Lord, and give not thy inheritance to the reproach, that the heathen should rule over us. Say, God forbid. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is our God? 18, the Lord said, then the Lord will be jealous for his land and pity his people. Shout amen.
Amen.
There are things that belongs to you in the hand of the enemy, which require praying and fasting for you to recover back. God said, go and praying and fasting. Let the heathen not rule my people. Let unbelievers not be a leader to my people. Let the agent of darkness not take my people for granted. Go for a fast. Let the whole assembly, the whole members of the church, come upon the Lord through praying and fasting and say, God, spare the church, spare the members, spare the brothers, spare the sisters, spare the elders, spare the pastors, spare the prophets, spare the children. This is the season, the period, the appointed time. You will remember the people you love in prayer. You fast for them. Because the situation they are in is not enjoyable. The condition you find them is not enjoyable. You love the church. You say, God, I'm fasting for church. You love the prophet. You say, God, I want to go into prayer for the prophets. Showing kindness and love is not calling carcass meeting at the back to destroy the person's image. The love you need to show for the person is to call prayer for the person. Hallelujah. Yeah. God told his prophet, call a solemn assembly for my people not to cry in 2019. Their blessings have been hijacked by the enemies. It's only praying and fasting that can recover him back. Since from first, I've been kneeling down on this altar. I never pray without my knees on the ground. For every angelic hours, 3 hours from 6 to 6 in the evening. Today is the 10th day. We have 11 days. Wait a minute. For you, for your families, and for the church. This is the way I'm showing my own love. That I love you. How are you showing your own love that you love me? How are you demonstrating your own love that you love the church? By spreading demonic dreams and the satanic informations from the pit of hell where they belong. This is the hour you need to say, I love this elder, I stand for him. I love the pastor, I stand for him. I love this brother, I stand for him. God, this year, this man will not suffer what he suffered last year. Amen. God, this year, this woman will not suffer what she suffered last year. This is the time. A solemn fast. Say a solemn fast.
A solemn fast.
This is the period you put your body to subjection. You put the carnality to the grave that the spirit will resurrect.
Hallelujah.
Because two of them are battling. Two of them are fighting. Two of them are in war. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your open heaven in 2019 need praying and fasting. Your dominion in 2019 need praying and fasting.
It happened to Jesus, our master, our Lord Jesus, our Savior. After he was baptized by John the Baptist, he came out from the river. Bible says he was praying and heaven opens. In the book of Luke chapter 3 verses 21 and 22. A good and fast reader, if you are there, please help me. Luke 3, 21.
Praise the Lord. Luke 3 from 21, I read. Mm-hmm. Now, when all the people were baptized.
Now, when all the people were baptized.
It came to pass.
It came to pass.
That Jesus also being baptized.
And Jesus himself, our Savior, being baptized by John the Baptist.
And praying.
And he was doing what?
Praying.
He didn't close his mouth and say, I am Jesus. I am the Father of all. I am the maker of the world. He was still praying.
The heaven was open.
The heaven did what?
Was open.
You open heaven with prayer.
22.
Hear me. Stop there, please. You open heaven with prayer. A woman that wants to conceive, your open womb need prayer. A woman that wants to marry, your marriage need prayer. A woman that needs husband for the best suitor to come need what?
Prayer.
A man that needs a wife, not a knife, need who? You need prayer. I will not say you need a woman. Everything on skirt is woman. But wife. All are not wife. Some are knife. Few are wife. I speak in parable. Not all that open ear, we are scared, are wife. Few are wife. Many are knife. They enter your life, they cut your neck. Shut fire. Women, don't be offended, I'm saying the truth. Yes. 22.
And the Holy Ghost descended.
And the Holy Ghost descended because he was praying. Heaven opened. Heaven did not just open because he was Jesus. Heaven did not just open because he carried anointing from birth. You may carry anointing from birth and anointing rotting in your belly. You may carry dignity from birth, dignity die in your stomach. You may carry anointing of excellency from birth, the anointing of excellency die and die with the grave. If you go to mantra, you see PhD holder that couldn't build one class. If you go to mantra, you see many rich men that their wealth did not manifest physically, but they are in the grave. The time of their burial, they go to their uncle's or cousin's house to host visitors. You don't get house. But their destiny carriers, the destiny die in their womb because they couldn't pray it out. Jesus prayed, his heaven opened, and Holy Ghost came down and announced his destiny. Holy Ghost came down and announced his ministry. Before you can be announced, you need to pray. Say
never.
You need to pray.
You need to pray.
Touch somebody, say never.
Never.
Open your ears.
Open your ears.
You need to pray.
You need to pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Prayer that works is prayer when you fast. Devil is always afraid of fasting. Because that time, many activities he used to do has been. Yes. Hear me? You may be praying and fasting. But the fasting refused to work. And the prayer refused to be answered. Because you have engaged yourself into some unexpectable activities. Hear me? Whenever you are into fasting, if you used to talk 1,000 times a day, you will talk at least 250. Hallelujah. Is it my day? Thank you. Hallelujah. When you are into fasting, if you used to gossip 1,000 times a day, you reduce it to 5%. It doesn't matter the dry fasting you are in, but the more you gossip, The 21 days dry has been a waste. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't know. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When you are fasting, some people engage into game. You reduce game. Some people are too busy with telephone. When you are fasting, you keep telephone aside. You have that time of telephone to pray. Some adults are too possessed with the spirit of watching cartoon. Some adults. Yes. There are some mamas say they carry telephone, then they play game with the telephone. Those people are possessed. That is the hour you need to pray. Even though you win 20 million in your phone with the game, they won't give you shishi. That's the time to pray. In the time you are fasting and praying, there are the places they don't need to see you. There are places you don't need to go. There are friends you don't need to meet or associate with till when you are done with your solo fast. Yeah, let me tell you something. When you go in into prayer with internal power, you come out with external power that your destiny may manifest. I don't know where you understand. When you look into, when you look into praying and fasting with internal power, then when you will come out, you manifest physically with external, external, external power. Then your destiny do what? Explode. The time of fasting is the time of sober reflection. It's not the time to engage yourself into immoral acts, into demonic activities, acrobatic discussions, liker to liker, worldly thoughts. If you are fasting and praying, being prayerful, being in church, devil will not use you in church. Because we'll be filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even in this fasting now, many are not fasting it. Many are not praying it. Because they have been possessed and demonized with the power from the pit of hell. Planning what evil to do. Planning what evil to carry out assignments. Because the Satan, their father, has commissioned them to do something. Say they have failed.
They have failed.
Then we fail, we will
win.
Give me Mark chapter 9, verse 28. Mark 9, 28.
And when he was come into the house,
when Jesus entered the house,
His disciples asked.
Use another microphone. Off that one. Nobody should use that one. Read, please. Yes.
And when he was come into the house,
His disciples came to ask him
privately,
Papa, why we couldn't cast out that demon? Why that prayer we prayed didn't work? Why the tongue will speak? Why nothing happened? Why the church we have been going, coming, nothing happened? And Jesus answered it.
Asking privately.
Privately, because they were ashamed.
Why could not?
Do you know why they were ashamed? Their level in church was too high. The position they occupied was too high. Disciples carrying big Bible like a seven books of Moses. Say, mercy, O Lord.
Mercy, O Lord.
The high who go the daytime. In the night, when everybody don't sleep, they come sneak. They come sneak, come enter. They need to explain. Yeah, Jesus told them,
why could not we cast him out? And he said unto them,
Jesus said unto them,
this kind can come forth by
this kind can take place by
nothing
but
by prayer.
Prayer and what?
And fasting.
For you to move forward to another level, you need prayer and fasting. For your level to change, spiritually and physical, you need praying and fasting. To stop the devil attacking you or the devil using you, you need praying and fasting. For you to convert your name from knife to wife, you need praying and fasting. For you to convert yourself from being ingrate to being grateful, you need praying and fasting. For you to convert yourself from being a nonentity to an excellency, you need praying and fasting. God used the time of prayer and fasting to remold, reconstruct, revive, restore, and reactivate.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to pray. You need to fast. For you not to be who you used to be. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am reading this. Have you finished it? 29.
It's finished, sir.
Okay, thank you. Pray and fast. Daniel said in the book of Daniel chapter 9, he said, from the first day I set my eyes towards the Lord. He didn't say he set his eyes towards his wife. He didn't say he set his eyes towards the husband. He didn't say he set his eyes towards his money or his fabrica. He set his eyes towards the Lord. To seek the face of the Lord and make supplications unto the God of heavens and the earth. Things are not working, you need praying and fasting. Life is not moving forward, you need praying and fasting. And there's something you need to know. When you are praying and fasting, your comportment and attitude matters a lot. Let me say, don't say, you can't just go like a wear and beat. Bro, this is why they work like this. You don't say with the fast. Hey, the sister called the water. Hey, come with Moody first. I say, I'm going to kill her. Sister called. This is the way the water like this. We'll be that fasting. What a prophet give us. Get me Matthew 6. In verses 16 to 17. It matters a lot how you comport yourself while you're praying and fasting. In the time you will bath, perfume yourself, wear the best clothes, and begin to go majestically. Therefore, you are a bastard. Yes.
Praise the Lord. Matthew 6 from 16 I read.
Yes.
Moreover, when you fast.
Moreover, when you are fasting.
Be not as the hypocrites.
Don't be like hypocrites.
Of a sad countenance.
Sad countenance.
For
sad. Don't frown your face. Don't be sad. Don't be moody face. Like say they cheat you. They don't want to treat you bad. This hunger strike. Somebody a punch. Come they go walk on and walk on. You know some people. If they are passing 6 to 6, if you read by 12, they go open cupboard, they check. So that you read this one.
fridge. What soup is that? You don't use mind, eat out. You don't use nose, eat out. So go there fast. Do I enter kitchen? Cook the food. Some bad dish I put for microwave. They went time. Many time. So that you go on. Hallelujah. That one don't be fast in the Efa. That one not Efa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Read the word of God. For
them disfigure their faith. Them disfigure their faith. Carry booty. Even they see you, they to greet you go have.
That they may appear unto men to pass.
Eh?
Verily I say unto you.
Jesus said, verily I say unto you.
They have their reward.
They have their reward already. Which means no answer.
17. But thou, when thou fast.
But when the girls are fasting.
Anoint their head.
Ew.
And wash their
shower head. Shower well, well. Enter your bath. If you get jacuzzi, yes. Enter there. Yes. Bath very well. Yes. Rub the best cream. Anoint yourself. Use the best perfume. Wear the best clothes. They work out like Christmas season. No let people know. Hey, no say with the fast. Like I just wear this one after fasting. I change. Who asked you? Who asked you? Hey! Please.
17.
Thank you. When you are fasting, comport yourself. Freshen up. Wear the best clothes. Come out majestically. They will come like a soldier waiting for one front. Death, because death will be on the first physical. You give a blow. What? Who sent you? He said in dream, you think that, oh, who sent you? But he said, they work like fowl, where they beat for bush. He said, they work like you go beat here. Hey, this fowl, oh. God punish the devil.
Yes.
Prepare yourself with praying and fast. It helps you to run away from temptation. It helps you to overcome temptation. It delivers you for them to not to use you. In your house, in the marketplace, even in church, them by using money. Kakabo group. Shout fire!
Fire!
Hallelujah. Don't mind me. Amen. Jesus asked the disciples a question I love. Jesus asked them in Matthew 26:40. He asked them, said, does it mean that you cannot keep awake to watch and pray with me for 1 hour? Does it mean that you cannot keep away? I am praying. I am awake. I am fasting. You are sleeping, snoring. Jesus was praying. The disciples were sleeping. Prophet was praying. The members at home enjoying. The Bible said, call your servant priest, everybody. Yes, did it.
Matthew 26:40.
Mm-hmm.
And he cometh unto the disciples.
When Jesus get up from the mountain, on top of the stone where he prays, he got up and saw his disciples. Three of them have slept already. You know, nobody slept, they are snoring. They begin to snore. Do you know that they are snoring even rich Madonna?
Because they don't eat in the back. Come use nostril. Come transport her. Come transport her. They enter bed. They don't know when they sleep up. Even single small prayer, even small prayer, crayfish own, they don't do. And Jesus came and saw them.
I found them asleep.
He found them asleep.
And said unto Peter.
He said unto the disciples.
Why could you not watch with me 1 hour?
Why can't you do prayer with me even one day? Even 1 hour. Even 1 tickly minute. I come here in the morning. Thank God for in the eye. He comes along with me. And others come in the evening when they close work. All these people wait for here now with big head. You know that the people coming to close this prayer, they don't reach there. You know, not only like, or to talk. They don't reach there when they come in the evening. I cannot say all this big head, wait for here. Now just come, receive miracle, go. Prophet, if you want fast, wait till we want our miracle. Prophet, if you want pray. What the hell was the miracle? If you know as you go to your God, go to your God, go to him. Give him a miracle. I want. You know, ask some will say, God not coming with prophets. The prophet I come. Hallelujah. Is it good?
No.
It's not good. These are all the disciples. I am praying for you and you are sleeping. Say error. Jesus himself requested the disciples to pray with him. How much more me? When we servant. Say error. He said, why can't you be away? Let us fight this battle together. Let us move this journey together. Prophecy has come that this is our year of dominion. Is it these few people coming to do the prayer, only the people receive dominion? How will others receive it on top of semo and pasta? Spaghetti and rice and stew. There is no man or woman that leave his or her farm to west in any season without going to plant a seed at that farm and expected harvest at the due time. What we are planting now is the seed. The praying and fasting is what? Seed. You are going to the farm, you plant it. Regularly you visit the farm to pursue the fowl and goats that will come and destroy the crops. Then you clear the grass that will come and kill the crops. The tares. Bible call it tares. You uproot the tares. Let it not kill the seed you planted. And at the time of harvest is the time of dominion. How can you go to harvest what you planted not? It's impossible. Can't. Finish it 40 part 1. Yeah. What? He said, my beloved brethren, what are prayer?
That ye enter not into temptation.
Because if you did not pray and fast, devil will go use you. You enter into what? Temptation. You fall the victim of the trap of the enemies.
The spirit indeed is willing.
He said, the spirit is willing, but this flesh.
But the flesh is weak.
The flesh. Now bread will enter water. The flesh is bread that enter Don't let the flesh deceive you. Don't let the flesh rob you your dominion. He told them, sleep not. Wake up. What does that mean? Somebody's destiny is sleeping. What does that mean? Somebody's marriage is sleeping. Somebody's unborn children are sleeping. Somebody's document is sleeping. What does that mean? Somebody's passport is sleeping. Somebody's sojourn. Somebody's house. Somebody's project. Somebody's building is sleeping. When you wake up in prayer, your destiny will come to manifest.
Amen.
It cannot just manifest if you did not do something. Spiritual exercise is required for the physical manifestation. You can't just sleep and wake up and say, let miracle happen. No. Bible has told you, in Psalm 23, he prepared a table before me in the presence of what? Canker worms, caterpillars, locusts, olocus, ibex, ayalalas, obus, ishangos. They are human beings. They are in the church. You see them in the street. You see them in your house. See them in the station. See them in McDonald's. See them in bar. See them inside bus, inside train, inside tram, inside flight.
Fabrica.
In Fabrica, they are there.
Yes.
Everywhere. If you do like this, they say no one buy.
Yes.
You talk like this, they say they walk and buy. You go like this, they say they walk away. You wear clothes like this, they say not style. Why don't you wear like this? You know, say another person wear like this. You don't know whether my leg and that person's leg are the same thing. You walk out like this, same way they walk out like this. They walk out because of that person. Who tell you? You say inside me. You do which? I take no high, they say I walk out because of this person they walk. Psychological demon. If you engage yourself into praying and fasting, you will not have time to think evil, to imagine evil, to plan evil.
They are going to eat grass.
Amen.
I speak with the blessing of God upon my head. They will eat grass.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To wake up with fasting. Say, enough! As I was 2017, as I was 2017, I can never and I will never be in 2019. Mm-mm. Do you know the reason why? When
I don't watch ball anyway, I don't belong to any club. I don't watch, I don't get time for that.
When Arsenal come defeat Chelsea, if they defeat them, their coach come carry them, go do strong training. They come know the reason why that goal took place. They come know who played that wing, where the ball from pass. They come rehearse and rehearse their practice. Then when they come the next tournament match, they would like to win. But it's only in Christendom they will defeat you and continue to defeat you and continue to defeat you. You don't want to fire back. Hey! There's one for you!
Stand on your feet.
Enough, please!
Enough!
There will not be no sin again!
Amen.
Any cause, let them go! Let them visit! With their demonic enchantment and satanic dreams, they will carry come, we will defeat them.
Amen.
Lift up your say, oh God, my Father.
Oh God, my Father.
Any personality.
Flying at day.
Flying at the night.
Flying at night.
Because of me.
Fly my pride. My father, my maker. Any personality. Flying at the day.
the night because of me. I see God will be lost on the earth. Everybody pray because of them will lost on the earth. Because I know who I am. The power in me will have jacked you. The power in me will have jacked you. They will be lost on the earth. They will melt away in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Savior, anyone wondering about for me will lost on the earth in the name of Jesus. Everybody begin to pray. I start begin to pray. Everybody that fly because of me, at the night, in the day, we run from the air. We run from the air. And melt away. And melt out of the surface of the air. So that is what I say for them. Because my Bible has said it. That no, I will, in the day, I will not fight my sins against the soul. In the night, you will not hurt me. That is what the Bible says. If you run from the day, you will die. You will die. At the night, we will lost. We will lost. Because my God has said it. So shall it be. Any personality,
any man or woman,
will walk.
Flying because of me,
die by fire.
By day and night,
fire. Die by fire. Any personality, fire because of me. And even in the night, die by fire. You will die in the night. You will die in the day. You will die in the day. In the name of Jesus.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. I'm gonna
come. I want to tell you something you need to know about the things of the Spirit.
Devil will not come as a devil to fight your glory.
Devil will not come as a devil to fight your blessing. Devil will not come as a devil to fight your ministry. Devil will enter into people to fight. Lift up your right hand.
Say in the name of Jesus.
Any
attempt of the devil, the devil is using to fight me, to fight my destiny, to fight this church.
Who defied my glory? Who defied my grace? Who defied my grace?
And amen.
Amen.
The rest of prayer. Say, whosoever that want me to fail,
whosoever that want me to fail,
let them be put to shame.
Let them be put to shame.
Hear me. I kneel on my knees. I say you will not fail.
Amen.
Under this my 21 days journey, you will not fail.
Amen.
I say you that believe in the oil I carry, you will not fail.
Amen.
Who said ever that want to fail? As my knees are on the ground, as a sacrifice unto Jehovah, unto our Tobia, may our enemies fail. May them fail. May them be disappointed. May them be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. Any group of people, open their ears to hear my news about us. Any set of people, open their ears to hear bad news against us, against this church. I kneel on my knees as a sacrifice unto our God, and I decree and I declare, let them be put to shame. Let them be disgraced. Let them cry our cry. Let them die our death. This prayer is irreversible. In the name of Jesus.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
If you have to do something for Jesus,
hallelujah.
Do something for myself. Waiting for grant to open to swallow them.
Amen.
Say we will.